Now we will learn multiplication theorem on probability. Multiplication theorem or multiplication rule of probability. If E and F, if E and F are two events associated to a sample space, if E and F are two events associated to a sample space, then the probability of occurrence of both the events E and F simultaneously, or the simultaneous occurrence of the events E and F, that is denoted by probability of E intersection F. So that is the probability of occurrence of E and F simultaneously, or simultaneous occurrence of the events E and F in a random experiment. So that is probability of E intersection F, and it can be calculated using the conditional probability formula. So P of E given F, conditional probability P of E E given F is equal to P of E intersection F divided by P of F. So when we cross multiply, P of E intersection F, that is equal to P of F into, we can cross multiply, P of F into P of E given F. P of E given F. So P of E intersection F is equal to P of F into P of E given F. And similarly, same rule we can write, P of F given E. P of F given E is equal to P of F intersection E, or P of E intersection F. E intersection F divided by P of E. So when we cross multiply, P of E intersection F, P of E intersection F is equal to P of E into P of F given E. So P of E into P of F given E. So we can write, or we will write, P of E intersection F is equal to, so here we have written P of E intersection F is P of F into P of E given F. And here P of E intersection F is P of E into P of F given E. P of E into P of F given E. So this is called a multiplication rule of probability. That is, if we have two events E and F, then P of E intersection F is equal to P of E intersection F is equal to P of E into P of F given E, or P of F into P of E given F. So that is multiplication rule of probability. So if you want to find the probability of two events simultaneously, simultaneous occurrence of events E and F, that is P of E into P of F given E. So this is conditional probability. So the probability of occurrence of event E, even the F, if E has already occurred. So probability of occurrence of F if E has already occurred. So that is multiplication rule on probability. And if we have three events, then we can write P of E intersection F intersection G is equal to same way P of E. P of E into P of F given E into P of G given E intersection F. So that is a multiplication rule. If we have two events E, F and G, multiplication rule of probability, if we have three events, then P of E intersection F intersection G is equal to P of E into P of F given E into P of G given E intersection F. And if we have one more event, E F G H, then it will be P of E, then P of F given E into P of G given E intersection F into P of H given E intersection F intersection G, etc. It is going on. If we have four events, P of E intersection F intersection G intersection H, then it will be P of E into P of F given E into P of G given E intersection F into P of H given E intersection F intersection G. So that is. So this is a multiplication rule on rule of probability. And E intersection F, P of E intersection F can be written like this. P of E intersection F is equal to P of E F. Both are same. So P of E. So this is that formula. P of E intersection F is equal to P of E into P of F given E. And P of E intersection F is P of F into P of E given F. And if we have three events, this is the formula. And if we have four events, so it will be like that. So that is multiplication rule of probability. Then now we will learn independent events. Independent events. So we can take one example, then we can find independent events. Independent events. Independent events. So here, suppose a random experiment. Draw a card from a pack of 52 cards. Draw a card from a pack of 52 cards. Then E and F are the events. E is the event. The card drawn is spade. So we can take the card drawn is spade. The card drawn is spade. And F. Card drawn is ace. So when we draw a card from a pack of 52 cards, then suppose we have two events, E and F. The card drawn is spade and the card drawn is ace. And we can find the probability of E. So the card drawn is spade. So total we have 13 spades, 13 upon 52. So that is 1 by 4. Then P of E given, P of E, then card drawn is ace, P of F, card drawn is ace from a pack of 52 cards. We have 4 ace, so 4 upon 52, so that is equal to 1 by 30. Then probability of E given F, so probability of E given F. We will write E, probability of E intersection F. Probability of E intersection F. So here E intersection F. The card drawn is a spade and a ace. So we have only one ace, spade ace. We have only one spade ace. E intersection F. E is card drawn is spade. We have 13 spade. And the card drawn is ace. We have 4 ace. And out of then E intersection F is the card drawn is spade and ace. So we have only one card, ace and spade. We have only one card. So the probability will be 1 upon 52. And here probability of E given F we can calculate. So probability of E given F is equal to P of E intersection F divided by P of F. So P of E intersection F, that is 1 upon 52, divided by P of F, that is 4 by 52. So when we simplify, we are getting 1 by 4. So here probability of E given F, that is 1 by 4, and P of E, that is also 1 by 4. So P of E and P of E given F, both are equal, that is 1 by 4. So this is probability of occurrence of E, that is 1 by 4. And this is conditional probability. Probability of occurrence of E if F has already occurred. The probability of occurrence of E, the probability of occurrence of E if F has already occurred. So that is 1 by 4. And the probability of occurrence of E, that is also 1 by 4. So here both the values are same. That means the probability of occurrence of E is not depending the probability of occurrence of F. So here probability of occurrence of E if F has already acquired, that is 1 by 4, and this is probability of occurrence of E, that is also 1 by 4. So from here we can say that the probability of occurrence of E is not depending on the probability of occurrence of F. So we can say E and F are independent events. So E and F are independent events. And similarly, if probability of F equal to probability of F given E, if both of them are equal, probability of F is equal to probability of F given E, and probability of E is equal to probability of E given F, then we can say they are independent events. E and F are independent. That means the probability of occurrence of E is not affected by the probability of occurrence of F. Probability of occurrence of E not affected by the probability of occurrence of F. And here, probability of occurrence of F is not affected by the probability of occurrence of E. Therefore, they are independent events. And if they are independent events, then we learned P of E intersection F by multiplication rule of probability. P of E intersection F is equal to P of E into P of F given E. That is multiplication rule of probability. So if they are independent, P of E into P of F given E and P of E F both are same. P of F given E and P of F both are same. So P of F given E can be replaced by P of F. P of F. So P of E intersection F is equal to P of E into P of F. So if E and F are independent events, then P of E intersection F is equal to P of E into P of F. So this result is important. Now, if E and F are independent events, if you want to show that the events given events are independent, then we have to show that P of E intersection F is equal to P of E into P of F. So they are independent. So the probability of occurrence of one event is not affected by the probability of occurrence of the other one. So they are independent events. Then we will learn some properties related to independent events. If A, B, C are independent events, then P of A intersection B intersection C is equal to P of A into P of B into P of C. If they are independent events, P of A into P of B into P of C. Then we will learn some properties. Independent events. Then, if E and F are independent, if E and F are independent events, independent events, then first one, E complement, that is E dash, and F are independent. If E and F are independent, then E complement or E dash and F, E complement, that is E, not E, not E and F are independent. Then second, if E dash and F are independent, then we can say that E and F dash are independent. Then E dash and F dash are independent. Independent. So we can say if E and F are independent events, then E dash and F dash are independent. So we can write if E dash and F dash are independent, then E and F are independent. So from here we can say if E and F are independent, then E dash, that means not E and not F, are independent. So if they are independent, then not E dash is E, and not F, that means E and F are independent. So these are the result associated to independent events. So now we will do exercise 13.2. to exercise 13.2. And here, question number 1, 13.2. P of A is given. P of A is 3/5. Then P of B is given, that is 1/5. Then find P of A intersection B if A and B are independent events. So P of A intersection B we need to find if A and B are independent events. If A and B are independent events, then P of A intersection B is P of A into P of B. So that is P of A, that is 3/5, and P of B, that is 1/5. So 3/25. So since A and B are independent, so A and B are independent, therefore P of A intersection B is P of A into P of B, that is 3/5 into 1/5, that is 3/25. Then second question, two cards are drawn at a random and without replacement from a pack of 52 playing cards. Find the probability that both the cards are black. So, second question. And before that, if you are not familiar with the playing cards, if you are not familiar with playing cards, then see, total number of cards, 52. Total number of cards, 52. In a pack of 52 cards, that means the total 52 cards are there, and in that 52 cards, sometimes you may get a joker, two or three jokers may be there, but that in 52 that joker is not included. Except jokers, we have 52 cards. Then that 52 cards are in two different colors. First one is red. We have half of them are red card, 26. And black cards, 26. Half of them red, half of them black. Then that red cards, in 10th standard you studied, red cards are diamonds. Diamonds, so diamond shape, and half of them, that is 13 diamonds are there. And diamonds and hearts, they are red cards. So hearts, that heart shape. So they are heart. So here that is also 13. Then black cards. We have spades. Spades. So that is, this is a spade card shape. Spades 13. And clubs. Clubs. That is this shape. Clubs. Clubs, that is also 30. So we have diamonds, hearts, so they are red cards, then black cards 13, and 13, that they are spades and clubs. Then these 13 cards, diamonds, hearts, spades, clubs, etc. So they are ace, A, K, Q, J. That means ace, king, queen, jack. Then the numbers from 2 to 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 cards. So, diamonds 13, same way, hearts 13, spades 13, and clubs 13. Then, here face cards. Face cards. So, king, queen, and jack, they are called face cards. So, face cards are king and queen, then jack. And here we have one king, diamond one king. The diamond one king, then hearts, spade, and jack. So we have four kings, then four queens, and four jacks. So the total number of face cards, that is 4 into 3, 12. So number of face cards, number of face cards, that is total 12. So here 4 cards, 4 king, 4 queen, and 4 jacks. So total 12 face cards. So these are the playing cards. So second question we will do. So here we need to find the two cards are drawn at random and without replacement from a pack of 52 playing cards. Find the probability that both the cards are black. Second question, from a pack of 52 cards, two cards are drawn at random and without replacement. From a pack of 52 playing cards, find the probability that both the cards are black. Probability that both the cards are black. Both the cards are black. So when we take a card from a pack of 52 cards, then the probability that it is black. So we have 26 black cards, and if we are taking a card from 52 cards, so the probability that the first one is black, that is 26 upon 52, then we are not replacing that card. Now when we take the second card from that 52 cards, total we have 52 cards, we have taken one card from that 52 cards, so the probability of getting the first card black, that is 26 upon 52, and we are not replacing that card, we are not keeping it back. Now we are going to take the second card from that pack of cards. Now we have 51 cards, we already taken one card, so now we have 51 cards, and that first card is black card. So we removed that black card from there. So now we have 25 black cards and total number of cards 51. So when we take second card from that pack, so you are taking one card, one black card from 25 cards. So 25 upon 51. So when we simplify, we will get the probability that both the cards are black. That is 26 upon 52 into 25 upon 51. Or we can do like this. Probability of E into probability of E into, then second one again, probability of E given E. That means if we have taken black card, then what is the probability that the second card is black? So the denominator will be 51, so that is the probability. Or we can do by permutation and combination. You are taking two cards from a pack of 52 cards, then we have 26 black cards, so 26 C2. You are taking two cards from 26 black cards, and you are taking two cards from 52 cards. So when you simplify, you will get a same answer, 26 C2 upon 52 C2. So like that also we can do that question. Then we will do third question. Question number 3. And here, a box of oranges is inspected by examining three randomly selected oranges drawn without replacement. A box of oranges is inspected by examining three randomly selected oranges drawn without replacement. If all the three oranges are good, the box is approved for sale, otherwise it is rejected. Find the probability that a box containing 15 oranges out of 12 are good and 3 are bad. So 12 good oranges, then bad oranges 3, and total of 15. And we will take 3 oranges one by one without replacement. And if all the 3 oranges are good, then it is approved for sale. And if one of them, or if all of them, or two of them bad, then it will not be approved. If all the 3 oranges are good, then it will be approved for sale. So from that 15 oranges, we are going to take one by one 3 oranges. So the probability that find the probability that a box containing will be approved for sale. Probability that the box is approved for sale. sale. So that is equal to, we can take the oranges one by one. So when we take first orange, it is approved for sale. It is approved for sale, that means all the three oranges are all the three oranges are good. That's why it is approved for sale. So first one is good, then second one is good, and third one also good. So if you want to get three good oranges, so when we take first orange from 15 oranges, the probability that the first one is good, that is 12 divided by 15 into, then the first orange we are not replacing. So now we have 14 oranges. One orange we have taken, that is good, and we are keeping inside. Then now we have 14 oranges, and the first orange was good. So now we have 11 good oranges, number of bad oranges same. Then when we take the second orange from here, what is the probability that the second orange is good? That is 11 upon 14. So 11 divided by 14 into. Now we have taken two oranges, second orange we are keeping aside. So now we have 13 oranges, and the bad orange is same because second one was good. So now here we have 10 oranges. So first one was good, then second one was good, then now we have 10 good oranges, and the total number of oranges 13, and we are going to take one orange from there, and that orange is good. So that's why it is approved for sale. So what is the probability that it is good? So that is 10 divided by 13. So when we simplify, we will get the answer. So that is the probability that the box is approved for sale. Then we will do question number 3. Sorry, fourth question. A fair coin and an unbiased die are tossed. A fair coin and an unbiased die are tossed. Let A be the event, head appears on the coin, and B be the event, 3 on the die. Check whether A and B are independent events or not. So first we will write the sample space. Fourth question, sample space. So here a fair coin and an unbiased die are tossed. So we have a coin and a die, unbiased die. Suppose we are tossing a coin. A fair coin and an unbiased die are tossed. Tossing a coin. Suppose we got a head. Then we will throw a die. So here, suppose we got a head. Then we will throw a die. So the outcome head, then 1. Head 2. So it can be head. Then it can be 1 to 6, any number. So the outcome head H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. Then if you get a tail here, then we will throw the die. Then that time also we can get any number from 1 to 6. So the sample space is H1, then H2, then H3, H4, H5. Then if you get a tail, we will throw the die once, then T1, then T2, then T3, then T4, T5, then T6. So that is the sample space. Total we have 6 plus 6 is 12 outcomes. Then here we have got two events A and B. And the event A. Let A be the event, head appears on the coin. Head appears on the coin. Head appears on the coin. A be the event, head appears on the coin. And B be the event, 3 on the die. 3 on the die. So that is the events A and B. Then we have to check whether A and B are independent events or not. If they are independent events, then P of A intersection B is equal to P of A into P of B. So we can find A intersection B. That is, head appears on the coin and 3 on the die. Head appears on the coin and 3 on the die. So we have H3, only one element. H3 and here A, even the A is H1, head appears on the coin. H1, H2, H3, H4, H5. H1, H2, then H3, H4, H5, then H6. So that is A. And B, B is 3 on the die. So H3, then T3. That is a T on three on die. So we have two outcomes. Here we have 3, and here also we have 3, H3, T3. Then A intersection B, so the common element is H3. So that is A intersection B. So now we can find the P of A intersection B. P of A intersection B, we have only one element, 1 divided by total 12. Then P of A into P of B. P of A is we have 6 elements, 6 upon 12 into 2 upon 12. So we will cancel 6 and 12. So we will cancel here 2 times, and 2 and 2 cancel. That is also 1 by 12. So P of A intersection B is equal to P of A into P of B. P of A intersection B is equal to P of A into P of B. Therefore, A and B are independent. A and B are independent events, because P of A intersection B is equal to P of A into P of B. Then question number 5. In question number 5, we have so here a die marked 1, 2, 3. A die marked 1, 2, 3 in red. And 4, 5, 6 in green is tossed. Let A be the event. So the sample space. Fifth question. A die is tossed. A die is thrown. Then the sample space. S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And here 1, 2, 3 in red color and 4, 5, 6 in green color. That is given. Then let A be the event. The number is even. A be the event. The number is even. And B be the event. The number is red. So we can find A. And are A and B independent? That is our question. So we will find the event A. The number is even. So 2, 4, 6. Even numbers. And B, the number is red. 4, 5, 6. Sorry, 1, 2, 3 are in red color. 4, 5, 6 are in green color. So the number is red. That means 1, 2, 3. Then A intersection B. A intersection B, that is common, that is we have only one element, that is 2. Then P of A intersection B. P of A intersection B, we have only one element divided by total 6. Then P of A into P of B. So P of A, 3 upon 6 into P of B, 3 upon 6. So 3 upon 6, that is 1 by 2 into here 1 by 2 and here also 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, 1 by 4. So P of A intersection B not equal to P of A into P of B. Therefore, they are not independent. Therefore, A and B are not independent. They are not independent because P of A intersection B not equal to P of A into P of B. So that is question number 5. Then we will do 6th question. So here E and F are events. P of E is given, P of F is given, P of E intersection F is given. Are E and F independent? Direct question, so we can do by yourself. Then we will do 7th question. Given that the events A and B are such that P of A is equal to 1 by 2 then P of A unit B equal to 3 by 5, then P of B equal to P, then find the value of P if they are mutually exclusive. If they are mutually, first part that is mutually exclusive. If they are mutually exclusive, and the second part, they are independent. If they are independent and if they are mutually exclusive, we need to find the value of P. So here P of A is given 1 by 2, P of A unit B is 3 by 5, and P of B, that is P, then find the value of P if they are mutually exclusive. That is the first case. And find the value of P if they are independent. So, mutually exclusive. If A and B are mutually exclusive, that means there is no common element between them. They are disjoint. If A and B are mutually exclusive, that means they are disjoint, no common element. So, if they are mutually exclusive, first part. If they are mutually exclusive, if A and B are mutually exclusive. Then A intersection B is equal to empty set. Therefore, P of A intersection B is equal to, if it is empty set, then P of A intersection B will be 0. Then we need to find the P of B. So P of A union B, P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So that is P of A. P of A union B, that is given 3 by 5, and P of A, that is 1 by 2 plus P of B, that is P, minus P of A intersection B, that is 0. Therefore, P is equal to 3 by 5 minus 1 by 2. So when we simplify, we will get the value of P. So 10 LCM, then 6 minus 5, that is 1 by 10. So that is the value of P. Then the second is, if A and B, B are independent. If A and B are independent. If A and B are independent, then P of A intersection B is equal to P of A into P of B. If they are independent, then P of A intersection B is P of A into P of B. Then we can use the same result. P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So that is P of A union B. That is P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B, that is P of A into P of B, because they are independent. Now we can replace their values. P of A union B, that is 3 upon 5, is equal to P of A, that is 1 by 2, plus P of B, that is P, minus P of A into P of B. So that is 1 by 2 into P of B, that is P. So from here we can find the value, that is 3 upon 5 is equal to 3 upon 5, we can take 1 by 2 from minus 1 by 2 equal to P minus half of P. That means 2P minus 1P, that is again 1 by 2P. When we take LCM, 2P minus P, that is 1P upon 2, that is 1 by 2P. Then when we simplify here, 10 LCM, then 6 minus 5, so here it is, yes. 3 by 5 minus 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by 2 into P. So 1 by 10 is equal to 1 by 2 P. Therefore P is equal to 1 by 10 into 2 by 1. 2 by 1. Therefore 1 by 5. So the value of P here 1 by 5. So here if A and B are independent, the value of P is equal to 1 by 5. And if they are mutually exclusive, the value of P is equal to 1 by 10. Then we will do question number 7 we have done.
Then we will do question number 8. 8th one.
If A and B are independent events, then P of A is given, then P of B is given. Then that question is very simple. P of A intersection B, P of A intersection B. That is P of A into P of B. P of A is given, P of B is given. Then P of A union B. That is P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. Then we will get answer. Then we will do question number 9. If A and B are two events such that P of A equal to 1 by 4, then P of B equal to 1 by 2, and P of A intersection B equal to 1 by 8, then find P of not A and not B. P of not A and not B. P of not A and not B. That means P of A complement. And that means intersection B complement. So P of not A and not B, that means P of A complement intersection B complement. That is P of A complement intersection B complement. That is A unit B all complement. We studied in 11th standard. A unit B all complement is A complement intersection B complement. Then P of A unit B all complement. So here we will write A unit B all complement equal to A complement intersection B complement. Then P of A unit B all complement, that is 1 minus P of A unit B. So P of A not A, P of A dash is equal to 1 minus P of A. That is 1 minus P of A unit B. That is P of A. P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. That is 1 minus P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So P of A, that is 1 by 4 plus P of B 1 by 2 minus P of 1 by 8. So when we simplify, you will get P of not A and not B. Then we will do question number 10. Tenth question almost the same. Events A and B are such that P of A question number 10. P of A is given 1 by 2. Then P of B that is given 7 by 12. P of A is 1 by 2, P of B 7 by 12. Then P of not A or not B. P of not A or not B equal to 1 by 4. So P of not A, P of not A or not B equal to 1 by 4 implies P of not A, that is A complement. P of A complement, here it is OR, that means union. A complement union, B complement, equal to 1 by 4. That is P of A complement union, B complement, that is A intersection B, all complement, equal to 1 by 4. So P of A intersection B all complement, that is A complement union B complement. A intersection B all complement is A complement union B complement. Or A complement union B complement is A intersection B all complement. So that is 1 minus P of A intersection B is equal to 1 by 4. So therefore 1 minus 1 by 4 is equal to P of A intersection B. Therefore, 4 minus 1, that is 3 by 4, is equal to P of A intersection B. Now we can find P of A into P of B. So P of A into P of B. P of A is 1 by 2 into P of B 7 by 12, that is 7 by 24. So here P of A intersection B not equal to P of A into P of B. Therefore, A and B are not independent. They are not independent because P of A intersection B not equal to P of A into P of B. Therefore, they are not independent. Then question number 11. Given two independent events A and B, such that P of A is given, P of B is given, find P of A and B. 11th question. P of A is given 0.3 and P of B, that is given 0.6. If two independent events A and B, so independent event, that is P of A intersection B, is equal to independent events, that is given P of A intersection B is equal to it's given two independent events A and B are independent. A and B are independent. So these are the given conditions. Then first part we have to find P of A and B. P of A and B, that is equal to P of A intersection B. That is P of A into P of B, because they are independent. Then we will get 0.3 into 0.6. So we will get. Then second part. P of A and not B. P of A and not B. That is P of A and intersection not B. That is B complement. If A and B are independent, then A and B dash are independent. We learned one property. So A and B dash are independent. So P of A into P of B dash. That is equal to P of A into P of B dash. That is 1 minus P of B. Now we can replace P of A 0.3. into 1 minus P of B 0.6. So when we simplify, we will get a second part. Then third one. P of A or B. P of A or B. That is P of A union B. That is P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. That is P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. They are independent, or we got here P of A intersection B. So we can write that value P of A into P of B. Now we can replace P of A, then P of B, then P of A into B. So when we simplify, we will get a third part. Then fourth one. P of neither A nor B. So P of neither A nor B. So that is P of neither A nor B. That means P of not A and not B. That is P of A complement intersection B complement. That is the meaning of this one. P of neither A nor B. That means P of not A and not B. That is P of A complement intersection B complement. That is P of A union B all complement. That is 1 minus P of A union B. So so here P of A union B we will get. Then 1 minus that value will be the answer. So P of A union B we will get from here. So when we replace, we will get that part. So that is question number 12. Then, sorry, 11th question. We will do 12th one now. So question number 12. And here a die is tossed thrice. A die is tossed thrice. Find the probability of getting an odd number at least once. A die is tossed thrice. find the probability of getting an odd number at least once. Probability of getting an odd number at least once. So let A be let a probability of getting an odd number at least one. So we can take let A getting odd number. Getting odd number in a single throw of die. Single throw of die. So suppose the event A getting odd number in a single throw of die. So probability of A getting odd number in a single throw of die. So the sample space will be in a single throw of die. The sample space 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And getting odd number, that means 1, 3, 5. So 3 upon 6, that is 1 by 2. So probability getting odd number in a single throw of die. And here, a die is tossed thrice. Find the probability of getting an odd number at least once. So probability of getting an odd number. Odd number at least once equal to 1 minus probability of not getting an odd number. So probability of getting an odd number at least once, that means at least one odd number, that means 1 minus probability of not getting any odd number. So that is 1 minus probability of not getting an odd number when we throw a die 3 times. That means 1 minus probability of first time we didn't get odd number. So A is getting odd number. So A complement, not getting odd number. Second time we didn't get odd number. Third time we didn't get an odd number. So 3 times we are throwing that die. And probability of not getting an odd number in 3 cases. That means probability of not getting odd number in first case, and not getting odd second case, and not getting odd third case. And here they are independent. So we can write 1 minus probability of A complement into probability of A complement into probability of A complement, since they are independent. They are independent. When we throw a die 3 times or 4 times, 5 times, etc., they are independent events, because the outcomes of the first one is not affected by the outcomes of the second, probability of occurrence. So P of A complement into P of A complement into P of A complement. That is 1 minus P of A complement. That is 1 minus P of A. P of A complement is 1 minus P of A. And here also 1 minus P of A. And here also 1 minus P of A. Then that is 1 minus, then in bracket 1 minus P of A, that is 3 by 6 odd number, so 1 by 2. Then again 1 minus 1 by 2, then 1 minus 1 by 2. So when we simplify, it is 1 minus 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. So that is 1 minus 1 by 8. So that is 8 minus 1, that is 7, 7 by 8. So that is the answer. 7 by 8. Now we will do question number 13. Two balls are drawn at a random with a replacement from a box containing 10 black and 8 balls. 8 red balls. Two balls are drawn at a random with a replacement from a box containing 10 black balls and 8 red balls. Question number 13. Here we have black balls. Black and red. 10 black balls and 8 red balls. And we have drawn 2 balls. Random. 2 balls are drawn at random with a replacement from. Then find the probability that first one. Probability that both balls are red. Probability that both balls are red. So both the balls are red. So with the replacement, we have taken 2 balls from that bag. So both the balls are red. So first one is red. The probability is 8 upon total 18. 8 upon 18 into second one. Probability of getting second one is red. So with the replacement. So we are keeping it back. Then first we are going to take one ball from that 18 balls. So what is the probability of getting that ball is red? That is 8 by 18. Then we are keeping it back. And we are going to take second ball from 18 balls. Then what is the probability that the second one is red? Again 8 by 18. So let me simplify a little bit. Then second part. The first ball is black and the second is red. Probability that the first one. First one is, first ball is black. And the second red. Second ball, second red. So the first one, black, 10 divided by 18. Then we will keep it back. Then we are going to take a second ball. And what is the probability that it is red? That is 8 upon 18. Then third one. One of them is black and the other is red. One of them is black and the other is red. That means probability that first one is black and the second red. Or second one black. First one is black, second red. Or first one is red, second black. So one of them is red. That means first ball. First ball is black. And second ball, red. Or first one black and second one red. Or first one red and second one black. So we will find their sum. Or probability that first ball is red. First ball is red and second is black. So the probability that the first ball is black, that is 10 divided by 18 into second ball red, that is 8 by 18 plus first ball red, that is 8 by 18 into second ball black, that is 10 by 18. So here both of them are equal. So 2 into 10 by 18 into 8 by 18. So when we simplify, we will get the answer of that question, third part. So question number 13 done. Now we can do question number 14. And here, 14th question. Probability of solving a specific problem. 14th question. Probability of solving a specific problem independently by A and B are 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. If A and B are independently solving a specific problem, then the probability that A solved that problem, that is 1 by 2, and B solves that problem, that is 1 by 3. So P of A is 1 by 2, and P of B, that is 1 by 3. That is given. Probability of solving specific problem independently by A and B, that is 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. If both try to solve the problem independently, find the probability that the problem is solved. First one, if they solve independently, that means the probability of occurrence of A is not affected by the probability of occurrence of B, and similarly probability of occurrence of B not affected by probability of occurrence of A. That means A and B are independent events. So P of A intersection B is P of A into P of B. Then probability that the problem is solved, first part. Probability that the problem is solved. That means the problem is solved. That means the problem is solved. That means A or B solved the problem. So here A and B are independently solving that problem. And the probability that A solves the problem independently, that is 1 by 2. And the probability that B solves the problem independently, that is 1 by 3. and they are solving independently. No discussion between them. So the problem is solved. That means either A solved or B solved. So the problem is solved, or A and B, both of them solved. So problem is solved. That means we will write P of A solved or B solved. A or B solved. That is P of A union B. P of A union B. The problem is solved. That is A or B solved. Then P of A union B. P of A union B is P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. That is P of A plus P of B. And in this case, they are solving independently. So P of A intersection B is P of A into P of B. Now we can replace that values. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 3. So when we simplify, we will get the answer. So that is probability that the problem is solved. Then second part. Exactly one of them solved the problem. Probability that exactly one of them. Exactly one of them solves. Exactly one of them. Solves the problem. So that means probability of exactly one of them solves. That means if A solved, then B did not solve. Or A did not solve and B solved. That is exactly one of them solved. So that means P of, suppose A solved and B did not solve. That is A solved but B did not solve. Or we can write a P of A did not solve the problem but B solved the problem. So that is probability of exactly one of them solved the problem. So here A and B are independent events. So we will write if A and B are independent, then A and B complement are independent. So P of A into P of B complement plus P of A complement into P of, sorry, here we made a mistake. Exactly one of them solves, that means A solved but B did not solve. Or A did not solve but B solved. That is P of A into P of B complement plus P of A complement into P of B. So P of A, that is 1 by 2 into P of B complement. P of B is 1 by 3, so P of B complement 1 minus P of B. Plus P of A complement, that is 1 minus P of A into P of B. So now we can replace their values. 1 by 2 into 1 minus 1 by 3. So 1 minus 1 by 3, that is 2 by 3. Plus 1 minus P of A. 1 minus 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2 into P of B, that is 1 by 3. So when we simplify, we will get a probability of exactly one of them solves the problem. We can do question number 15. One card is drawn at random from a well shuffled deck of 52 cards. In which of the following cases are the events E and F are independent? So that question we will do. The card drawn is paired. So we will do one part from question number 15. So first part we can do. One card is drawn at a random from a well shuffled deck of 52 cards. In which of the following cases are the events E and F are independent? So the card drawn is spade. The card drawn is spade. And the event F. The card drawn is ace. The card drawn is an ace. Then we want to check whether E and F are independent or not. So the card drawn is spade. So probability of E. The card drawn is spade. So we have total 13 spades. So the probability of E is equal to 13 divided by 52. So when we simplify, 1 by 4. Then probability of F. The card drawn is an ace. So total we have 4 aces. So 4 upon 52. So when we simplify, we will get a 1 by 13. Then P of E intersection F. And here the card drawn is spade and the card drawn is an ace. So E intersection F, that means a spade and ace. So spade and ace, we have only one card, that is a spade and ace. So a card spade ace, that is one only. So 1 upon 52. So now we can verify P of E into P of F. So that is P of E 1 by 4 into P of F 1 by 13, that is 1 by 52. So P of E intersection F is equal to P of E into P of F. Therefore E and F are independent. They are independent events. So that is first part of. Then similarly we can do second part of. The card drawn is second part. In second part of, the card drawn is black. The card drawn is black. And second event, the card drawn is king. King. Then the events. The card drawn. And here P of E. The card drawn is black. So total we have 26 black cards. So 26 upon 52. That is 1 by 2. Then the card drawn is king. So total we have 4 kings. So 4 upon 52. That is 1 by 13. Then E intersection F. The card drawn is black and king. So in black we have spade and the clubs. Spade and the clubs. And we have 2 black kings, a spade king and a club king. So the probability of 2 black kings, therefore probability is 2 upon 52, that is 1 upon 26. Then P of E into P of F, that is 1 by 2 into 1 by 13, that is 1 by 26. So here P of E intersection F is P of E into P of F, therefore E and F are independent events. Then we will do third part of that same question. And here in third part, the card drawn is a king or a queen. Card drawn is a king or a queen. King or queen. And the card drawn is a queen or jack. A queen or jack. So the card drawn is a king or a queen. So total we have four kings and 4 queens. So king or queen, that means 4 kings or 4 queens. So that means 4 plus 4, 8. So 4 plus 4 divided by 52, that is 8 by 52. So that is, we can divide it by... we can divide 4 by 26, that is 2 by 30. Then a card drawn is a queen or jack, same. We have 4 queen and 4 jacks. So again 4 plus 4 upon 52, that is 8 by 52, that is 2 by 30. Then P of E intersection F. So here king or queen. And queen or jack. So here queens common. So we have 4 queens. So the probability 4 upon 52. 4 upon 52 because E intersection F. So in E intersection F we have all the queens there. So king or queen. Then queen or jack. So E intersection F is only queens. So 4 upon 52. then P of E into P of F, that is 2 by 13 into 2 by 13. Then that is 4 by 13 into 13. So 13 square. So they are not equal. So P of E intersection F not equal to P of E into P of F. Therefore E and F are not independent. So they are not independent because here P of E, that is 2 by 13, and P of F, that is 2 by 13, and their product not equal to 4 by 52. Therefore, they are not independent. So that is 15th question. Now we have one more question. That is question number 16. So, 16th question. In a hostel, 60% of students read Hindi newspaper, 40% read English newspaper. In a hostel, 60% read Hindi newspaper and 40% read English newspaper. Then 20% read both Hindi and English newspaper. A student is selected at random. Find the probability that she reads neither Hindi nor English newspaper. Then second case and third case. So probability of 60% of students read Hindi newspaper. So probability of H, Hindi newspaper. 60%, that is 60 upon 100. Then 40% read English newspaper. So probability of reading English newspaper, 40%, that is 40 upon 100. Then 20% read both Hindi and English. That is probability of E intersection F. That is equal to 20 upon 100. 20%. Then A part, probability of. Find the probability that she reads neither Hindi nor English. Neither Hindi nor English. So that is probability of neither Hindi nor English. That is probability of neither Hindi. That means not Hindi. That is H complement. Neither Hindi nor English. That is intersection E complement. So that is P of neither Hindi nor English. That means not Hindi and not English. That is H complement intersection E complement. That is P of H unit E all complement. That is 1 minus P of H unit E. That is 1 minus P of H unit E. That is P of H plus P of E minus P of H intersection E. So here all the values given, 1 minus P of H, 60 upon 100 plus 40 upon 100 minus 20 upon 100. So when we simplify, we will get the first part. Then second part. Probability that she reads Hindi newspaper. If she reads Hindi newspaper, find the probability that she reads English newspaper. So here one condition is given. If she reads Hindi newspaper, that is the given condition. If she reads Hindi newspaper, find the probability that she reads English newspaper. So probability of English E upon H. So if she reads Hindi newspaper, find the probability that she reads English newspaper. So P of E given H, that is P of E intersection H divided by P of H. So P of E intersection H, that is given 20 upon 100 divided by P of H. P of H, that is given 60 upon 100. So when we simplify, 2 by 6, that is 1 by 3. Then C part. If she read English newspaper, find the probability that she reads Hindi newspaper. So the given condition, if she read English newspaper. So find the probability that she reads Hindi newspaper. That is probability of H given E. Same way we can find P of H intersection E divided by P of E, that is P of H intersection E, that is 20 upon 100 upon P of E. So 40 upon 100, so that is 2 by 4, that is 1 by 2. So now we got P of all the three cases,